Hi, it's me, Baronian. Today I bring you another short analysis, this time for Healing Mystic. He asked me to watch two of his games, and we will do that. But first I will show you his deck. He's playing an aggro Burn Fae deck, which looks pretty good. His 4 drops are Scorn and Thunderhorn, and his end of the mana curve is with 5 mana Luminous Charge. Other than that, he has the Bloodbound Mentor, Cryptographer combo to produce a lot of BBS, Warbirds, and some face damage with Warlock, and also Conceding Shroud to save himself, and some removal. Okay, so let's jump into the game. The first one is against a Ragnora. And we will look at the first two turns, because these are the pivotal turns in this game. First, he didn't mulligan anything. I personally would have replaced the Hasten Prison, because free play is good, it offers some stat, but other than that, I would like to have a 4 drop. And there's already Aspect of Shimsa and also Frigid Corona, so enough removal from my opinion. So I would have replaced that one. Let's see. Ragnora is opening with a Cryptographer. Classic move. And plays the Free Blade. And the opponent plays a Progenitor. So, this turn, Healing Mystic replaced the Frigid Corona. I would have replaced the Hasten Prison because I think Corona is better, because it can also stall and gives you a card. And you don't want to use the Hasten Prison right now. You don't want to use it on opening Gambit minions like Progenitor or Crypto. So I think that would have been a better replace. But let's see. Let's see what he does. Plays Aspect of Shimsa on the Progenitor. Yeah, okay. I can see why. I mean, if this is a fast game, then a 5-4 can be hurting. But this was a misplay. So, he had to move up to this tile and place the crypto here on the mana tile to be able to use the Warbird, the BBS, to clear the crypto and clear his whole board to win initiative. An alternative play would have been if you wanted to save the Aspect of Shimsa, to play the Scorn here before the free play is moving to block the mana tile. And then trade the Free Blade into the 5-4 and kill the Egg with Scorn and remove the Crypto with face. So you would have gotten a 4-4 on board, and he cleared his board and kept the Aspect of Shimsa in your hand for some bigger threat like Lava Slasher or another Progenitor or Mercantor or whatever. Maybe a buffed Ripper, who knows. But this is also fine, except, and that's a big problem, this movement here. The crypto has to be here to kill the 2-2. And you see, this gets punished. Also, it would have denied the mana tile for him. Also an advantage. So here's the Golem Intelligist and some Flesh Reincarnation, probably Lava Slasher or Mackenna. No, Mackenna doesn't work. Lava Slasher to kill that one together with the crypto. And then a greater fortitude. And now he cleared a whole board and you have to face a 2-3 and a 6-4. He's down in hand size, so that's an advantage, but this is a pretty intimidating board. And especially with Ragnora's burst potential, this is really difficult to come back. Let's watch this turn. Yeah, so don't replace your only minion. This was your only minion. You have so much removal here. Why do you replace that minion? Could have replaced a Hearthstone Prison. Don't want to play it anyways. Except on that, and that's not worth it. But you don't want to play it on a Lava Slasher. So, could have should have kept the Scorn. Because it's one of your strongest minions in the deck anyways. Stat line wise. And you need a ping for the X. So, that was a problem. You could... didn't change anything in that game, but in generally. Using Aspect Chimsa on that one is fine, because going down 6 damage with the Snowpiercer is brutal, but he got a 5-4, so you were really unlucky. Another thing, a little small thing, I would have moved here, because if he wants to hit you, you have to come down here. And then you can run away next turn and play something here which can't be hit by Lava Slasher. And that's pretty important. I mean, it didn't matter in this game because he had Mercantor, but still. So, to repeat what was the problem here. You mispositioned on your second turn and didn't use the mana tie to clear the whole board so he could clear your board. And yeah, and from that on you were on the losing side of the game. And he had good draws. He played 2 Lava Slashers and 1 Mercant in the game, so this is pretty good.